Tonight, lawmakers are demanding answers about how your stimulus dollars are being used to create jobs.
When the stimulus program started, the White House promised taxpayers they'd be able to track the money.
KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney reports tonight there are problems.
We're at the Federal Building in downtown Kansas City, and we thought we would track where the stimulus money's going. So we picked Johnson County, Missouri. That's Warrensburg and the Whiteman Air Force Base. Now, the government says they're getting $23 million in stimulus funds, but another private site says they're getting $111 million. See the problem?
The website recovery.gov is the official site to check how they're spending the stimulus fund, but it's not the only one. A private site, recovery.org, has been praised for doing a better job of posting stimulus spending. So let's see. Johnson County, Missouri has 52,000 folks and an unemployment rate twice as large as normal. It has Central Missouri State University and the Whiteman Air Force Base with the B-2 bomber. All of them are receiving stimulus money, and the government says it totals $23.6 million. But the private site says it's a lot more than that, $111 million. A difference of $87 million. How can that be? It might be how they're counting the stimulus money at Whiteman. Look at this. The private website, recovery.org, shows a $49.5 million contract for multiple projects at Whiteman. But officials there say little, if any, of the stimulus money is in that big contract.
So is it accurate for anyone to include that contract of 49.5
No.
as stimulus money?
No, you couldn't do that.
Now, Whiteman is getting stimulus money, $13 million, but from other contracts.
This stimulus money was focused and added right to those infrastructure projects that we typically have a difficult time getting money for up front.
One of the operators of the private site, Micheal Balsam, says comparing the two sites are not apples to apples. And that may be why it's difficult to track. They're working with different numbers. Now, Washington promised transparency, that folks would be able to see where the money goes. But this fall, the General Accountability Office says the stimulus program is facing some reporting and accountability challenges. Still, the work goes on. This is a crew replacing a water filtering system at Whiteman. And part of the trouble may be that the stimulus program was assembled so quickly, and in that early phase, the money came flooding out.
It was planned in a short amount of time. That's true. And some of those estimates could have been fairly dated, you know, when they went in there. So that's a problem.
Yaple says the later estimates were more accurate, and the Corps is trying to be meticulous about the money. Laura, Larry, back to you.
Thanks, Micheal. If you would like to find out about stimulus spending in your area, go to KMBC.com. We'll link you to the site. If you find things you're concerned about, let us know. We'll check it out.